Hello. In this video, I want to talk about optimizing Time Machine backups. So, Time Machine is backup software for a Mac, and it's probably very popular. You can back up to local USB drives. You can back up to network. So, in order to optimize that, Time Machine backs up, like, say, a Word document you're working on, but it also backs up lots of system files and cache files and things like that. And you can exclude those files to not back them up because they're kind of unneeded. They take up space, it takes time, etc. So the things I'm going to talk about in this video, you can actually use with other backup software on a Mac. And also the concepts in general you could use on Windows and Linux in some ways. But for this example, I'm using Time Machine. So right now, Time Machine just triggered, actually, and it's backing up. It says 68 megabytes of 378 megabytes, and I haven't done a lot on this machine, and we'll look at into this, what it's actually backing up here. So while this is finishing, I want to talk about a couple of things that we, different types of optimizations you can make. So one are unnecessary files to backup, which would be like log files. So you probably don't need log files. And as I'm going through this, just keep in mind that if you have inexperience with this stuff, you probably shouldn't touch it in general. So, you know, be careful with what you're doing. You know, that being said, you know, if you do have some experience, I think there are some optimizations you can make. So, so you have logs that are unnecessary. You have redundant data that is already backed up elsewhere. So there'd be like cloud synced things like your iCloud, things that talk to iCloud. You might have Google Drive, Dropbox, Microsoft OneDrive. The files on there, if you're syncing them to the cloud, you may not need to back those up. So that's something you need to determine for yourself. Another thing, is software that can be reinstalled. So on a day-to-day basis, you're not going to find that it's going to back up. Say you have Word installed on the machine, it's not going to back that up all the time. It's going to back it up once and you'll be done with it. So if you have a small backup drive, you may not want to back up your installed software because you don't have room on it. If you have a large backup drive, it may not matter. You back it up once and then you don't touch it again unless there's an update. And then another thing is you can potentially exclude your mail, your calendar, your contacts, if those are synced. That goes kind of back to the things that are synced with the cloud, but you may want to back up your mail locally. You know, I have mail on multiple machines, so I might want to back it up on one machine and on another one, but I don't need to back it up twice. So, so what we want to do here is look at what's being backed up. So there are some tools we can use to do that. One is this tmutil. So when you run this command here, this sudo tmutil, let me see if I can make this bigger. Okay. So we have this tmutil listbackups. So when you run this command here, it will list your backups. If you run this, the first time you run it, it'll say the operation cannot be completed because it doesn't have access. So what you want to do is go into your system preferences and then security and privacy, and you'll see it here. It says that, on the left we have different apps or different I don't know what you'd call them, you know, privacy settings. So we want to go down to full disk access, and then I need to unlock here. Okay, so you're going to unlock this so you can make changes. We'll click full disk access. I'll hit add, and then I'll add the terminal in there. So terminal is under utilities, applications, utilities, and then terminal. I'll hit open. And it says terminal will not have full disk access until it is quit. So I'll say quit now. And then I'm done here. I'll open up my Time Machine again so we can kind of keep watch of it. So now I will open the terminal again. So now we can type in sudo tmutil list backups. And since you type sudo, you'll need to type your password. And this will list backups. This will take a minute. I would make this font bigger, but this is going to take up a lot of the screen, so I can't really make the font bigger. I am recording this at 720p, so when you watch it on a like a 1080p monitor, it'll be kind of blown up a little bit. So so now Time Machine is finished running. We'll let this list the backups, and then we'll go from there. Okay, so this has listed the backups, and I haven't been running a Time Machine on this machine for a long time. You can see them. It will have the date here, and then this is like the time. It looks like 10 o'clock is when this one ran. So what we can do now is we can compare different backups. So I can say sudo tmutil compare, and then we need to put the path to two of these backups. So we're going to compare them to each other. So I'll copy and paste one of these in, and I'm putting quotes around this. I'll copy the one down below. And when I run this, it will show the files that changed between backups. So, looks like there's a lot of Visual Studio code here. I wonder if that updated maybe. Yeah, this is pretty big. This Visual Studio code, it's a lot on here. Now on the left side here, you'll see either a plus, minus, or exclamation point. Minus means the file was removed. Exclamation means it was changed. And a plus means it was added. And then you'll see how big it was. So we have a lot of stuff coming up here. You'll see here, I think I saw some mail. This is mail getting backed up. Here's some spotlight information, which is like the internal search. Here's some preference files. You probably would want preference files, but maybe not some of these Safari files. So I'll let this finish. Okay, so it's finished. So it says we added 4 megabytes, removed 7.2 megabytes, and we changed 315.6 megabytes. So I'll scroll through this real quick. We'll look, this is something I've already looked up. This here, this UUID text is some kind of logging, and I don't feel like I need to back that up. Maybe you do, but I don't. So I want to exclude that. So if you go into the Time Machine here, you can click on options and you can exclude items from the backup. So we'll hit the plus here. And I've already gone into here. I'm into this path that's Macintosh HD private var DB, but this can be hard to get to. So I'll give you a little tip. If you go to your finder here, you can go to go to folder, and you can enter the path in, and that will start with private var DB. And that will open up. Okay, so once you've opened this up, you can drag from one to the other and it will take you to that directory, and now you have access to this. Otherwise you probably won't see this because this is hidden. So alternatively, you can go to the command line and you can say open and put the path in there, and that will open that up in the finder also. So you can just type open private var DB or just private even. It'll get you into that directory. So we want private var DB UUID text. So I'll go down here and I'll select this and I'll hit exclude. And it adds it to our excludes. And then I'll hit save. So what I'll do now is I have not done much right now. Yeah, I mean, you've watched this video. I haven't gone in and edited Word files. So I'm going to go here and force a backup. I like to turn on this show time machine in the menu bar. So I can go up here and just force the backup. And this will back up, and I'll probably speed up the video here. And when we come back, we'll look at what changed while I wasn't really doing a whole lot. Okay, so you see it's says it's backing up 387.8. We'll watch and see if that's what we see down here. But while that's finishing up, I want to go over something. I found this on a Stack Exchange article. I'll put a link in the description to a couple of different articles on this topic that you might want to go through. But I found this simple script that will kind of automate this a little bit. So actually, I should have it in my history. So I'll see if I can bring it up. Okay, so this here will kind of automate what I was doing. So you do sudo tmutil listbackups. That will list the backups. You pipe that to tail, and tail dash two will pull up the last two lines in the list. So you might have 100 backups. You want to pull up the last two to see what changed. This sed is a stream editor, so this will, when you pipe it to sed, this will add quotes to those two lines. And then xargs will pass this to the tmutil compare. So if you run this line here, it will automatically bring up the comparison between the two. Let's see if this is finished. So this is finished. I'll hit this, and you might notice in my history here, I put greater than tmlist.txt. So you can also write this to a text file using that, and then you can just open up tmlist if you don't want to have to scroll through it. So I'll run this. It'll ask me for my password. This might take a second. Okay, so it said it was backing up 387.8. I think it was what it was. This says it added 300, removed 233, and changed 34. I don't know how they get their math, do their math, but if you're looking closely up here, if I can even find it right here, this subtracted 233. This is the UUID text that we added to the exclusion, so this is no longer going to show up in the backup. And let's see if there's anything else here we can go through. So these are some caches, it looks like. I'm not sure what those are. So when you find something, you can Google it usually and find out what it is. Like there's this ZZ. This looks like some sort of a log file. So I might Google that and see what people say it is on the internet, and then I can determine if I want to remove it. So, and I'm kind of looking, I start big, there's these diagnostics files. I'm guessing I don't need these, but there's only three of them. So I might look for bigger things first and then come back to those later. Let's see what else we can find here. So here is something that says Google software update. So this would be for Chrome, and I might determine that I don't really need to back this up. I don't know what it is, but chances are I don't need to back it up. So I can go into my options here. I can add here. Let me go to my desktop. And then I need to go to library, and that's not going to be showing up. So again, I'll use that trick I talked about earlier and go to folder. Type a tilde and then library. That'll open up library, and I just drag any of these folders over. That gets me in, and then I can move around from there. So I'll back up from library. I'll go to Google, and there's this software update. So I'll exclude that. It's only 4 megabytes, but sometimes these things are backing up all the time and changing and, you know, adding in stuff that you don't really care about. So, not a lot else here I can see. I have noticed, like, my calendar, which I synced to the iCloud, had, you know, like 100 files or something. So that's something I might add in there. You know, you can go through and just, you know, back this up and then run it again, back it up and run it again, and just see kind of what things are getting backed up that you may not need. Like I say, Google is your friend. You can go on Google, look through things, and, you know, see if they're relevant, see if they need to be backed up, and then add that to your exclude list. So after a while, you'll have a pretty large exclude list here, and then your backups will be smaller, faster. You're really only backing up the things you care about. You're not backing up a bunch of, you know, log files, things like that. So so that's kind of the basics I want to go over. Like I said, I'll put links to descriptions in there. I back up to a Synology NAS, and I have a whole bunch of videos on that, including how to set up Time Machine on that. So I'll put a link in the description to that too. But if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you have anything, you know, any more suggestions on this topic, things you do, things that you can exclude that you can think of, go ahead and add those down below. I appreciate that. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I'd love if you could do that. And thanks for watching. Goodbye.